Good morning, children. Welcome to our class today. The topic that we are going to study today is diary writing. I'm sure you all know what diary writing is. You studied this in class 4. Now in class 6, we are going to have some added features in the topic diary writing. Let us start with it. The first thing you need to know is, why is diary writing important? Why do we need to write a diary? So the answer is, diaries are a great way to keep track of the past, analyze the present, and think about the future. So if you write about your day-to-day happenings into your diary, you can keep a track of whatever has happened in the past with you or around you. You can also analyze the present, that whatever is happening in the present, how is it like, and think about the future. And if you have some future plannings to do, you can note that down in your diary as well. Now, what can we record in a diary? Now, are there some specific guidelines as to what we can record in a diary? Let us see. In a diary, you can record about celebrations. If there's any celebration, a New Year party or a birthday party or maybe a festival like Diwali, you can note it down in your diary. How did you spend it or how do you plan to spend it? Anything. Second, you can note about disasters. So now you know that the corona virus outbreak is going on. This is a disaster. People's lives are being affected all across the world. Together with the coronavirus, we are also dealing with forest fires. We are also dealing with earthquakes, cyclones, storms. So every different kind of disaster which is going on in the world, you can write about them. Or not only at this time, if any other time something disastrous is happening which you don't like or which you are very worried or concerned about, you can note it down. That is a very good way to release your stress. Next, you can write about any important information, any information that you would like to note down in your diary so that you can remember or you can make a note of it. You can write down that as well. Apart from this, in your diary, you can also note down any advice, an advice that some person has given you, any of your ideas or any recipe. Maybe you learnt a new, you know, a new very exotic cuisine you have learned how to cook. So you can note down the recipe as well. So now I have just listed 6 of the things that you can write in a diary, but it is not limited to these 6. You can write anything and everything that comes into your mind when you are engaged in diary writing. Alright, let's move on to the next part. So a diary is a record of special events in one's life arranged by date. Okay, so if there's anything special that has happened with you and you want to make a note of it, you can put it into your diary. Alright, and you have to arrange this by date. Alright, so the date has to be there. So what can such special events be? Wow, today I became the class monitor. So the day that you are chosen as the class monitor, it is a special day for you. So you can make notes of anything like this. Or if somebody gifted you a bicycle on your birthday, that is also a special day for you. So you can make notes of anything like that. One may also record feelings, ideas, or thoughts such as excited, sad, angry, sick, surprised, happy, unhappy, bored. Now, any of your feelings, how do you feel at the moment? If you have no one to talk to, it is a very good activity to open your diary and start writing into it. Expressing feelings into your diary is a very good way of releasing stress and pressure. Next, if you have any idea, so maybe there's a class project going on where the teacher has asked you to come up with an innovative idea. There, if you have a nice idea for the project and you want to discuss that with the teacher the next day in school, you might take up a pen, take up your diary and start writing into it. This is also a thing that you can record in your diary. Lastly, if you have any thought, you know, a positive thought, a powerful thought, a motivational thought, you can put it down in your diary. These are a few things which can go into your diary. One can add drawings or stick souvenirs such as a flower or photographs to store memories. Now, if you want to make record of any memory that you've had, then you can stick it into your diary. It can be flowers or photographs or whatever. It might look like this. That's a leaf on the diary and that's a photograph. If any of you have read the book, The Diary of Anne Frank, would know that the second picture here, the girl here is Anne Frank. If you've not read the book, read the book, The Diary of Anne Frank. It is an amazing book. Next, some features of diary writing. Now, what are the features? Starts with the day and date. The first and the most important thing to put in your diary is the day and the date. Now, when you're doing diary writing in school, if you don't write the day and the date, you would lose out. You would lose out on the marks. So be very careful about it. Sometimes when you're writing a diary, you might address it to a particular person. For example, if you want to talk to a friend about a problem or a conflict that you've had with him or her, and you're not being able to talk to him or her, you can put it into your diary. It is written in the first person. First person is like I and me. So I would say, I went to school today. I had lunch with my friend. So that is the first person. A record of the happenings of the day. You can record whatever has happened with you in a particular day. A spontaneous expression of emotions. Spontaneous means sudden and uncontrolled. So if you have any emotional expression, you can put that into your diary as well. Sometimes the diary is given a name. A diary is maintained by an individual and is not maintained for public viewing. So one can be very honest with the diary. However, in a classroom situation, one has to be diplomatic. Now, when you're maintaining a diary of your own, which is going to be at your home, it is not important for you to think and write. You can write anything and everything that you wish to write because it is only for you to write and to read and to view the diary. Nobody else is allowed to touch the diary, right? So when you're doing diary writing, you can be very honest, you can be very open about your feelings. But when you're doing a diary writing in school, the topics are going to be given to you. Here the teacher is going to read and correct your diary writing. That is why you have to be diplomatic. Diplomatic means that you have to think and write. You cannot just write anything and everything that comes up to your mind. Diary writing should follow the normal rules of any good writing, like sentence construction, paragraphs, ornamentations in language, etc. So because this is a writing skill for you all, it is important to follow the rules of any good writing. Don't think that because this is diary writing, you can write short forms, you can use any casual word. You cannot do that. You have to use good English, wherein your sentences should be constructed properly. Full, complete sentences should be written. Paragraphs should be very well maintained. And ornamentations in language. Here you can use the figures of speech to make your language look beautiful, to enrich the quality of your language. These are the basic rules of diary writing. Now here there's an example. It's given in your book. I want you all to read this on your own. But what I want you all to understand here, see, let's read the question first. Imagine you were marooned on an island. Marooned means you're stuck on an island after a shipwreck. Describe your adventures on the island and narrate how you were rescued in the form of a diary. So now when you're stuck on an island and you're not being able to get away from there, that means it's going to be for more than one day. When you're given a topic like that, be very careful that your diary writing should be for more than one day. It can be say for 3 to 4 days, or if you want to write more, 5-6 days, like that. Does not have to be very long, but has to be very descriptive. Here, this diary writing has been stretched over 5 different days. Similarly, whenever you are given a topic where you have to describe your experience of going somewhere, please don't make it for one day. When you're already there, make it for a longer time. Okay, so how do you start? You start with the day first. So it's Tuesday, 22 June, 20XX. You can also write 2020, that is also correct. Then 10 p.m. So first comes the day, then comes the date, then comes the time. Children, be very careful about the format. This is exactly how you will write into your English 1 notebook and also for your examinations. Then, when you're writing this, see how it starts. Today, I had one of the most terrifying experiences of my life. I was sleeping in my bunk on the ship when I felt a sudden jolt. My head banged against the ceiling and I passed out. When I woke up, I was lying on a sandy beach. I realized that I was marooned on a deserted island in the Pacific. I felt scared, yet I thanked fate for having spared me my life. Now, do you see that you're using the first person over here? I, you're using I because you're talking about yourself. And also that I had one of the most terrifying experiences because this has happened. Then you can start explaining your experiences on the island. You will read this on your own. I'm not reading the whole thing. It's there in your book. You can read it from there. Now, the first topic that you all need to do in your English 1 notebook is you have recently met Sachin Tendulkar at Eden Garden, Kolkata. Write a diary entry describing the way you felt after meeting him. So now you went to Eden Garden to watch a match. There you met Sachin Tendulkar and you have to write how you felt. Now, because this is a short incident, you can write it only in one form, like only one diary entry for this. So let's see how will we do it. Start with the day, date and time. The format is day, date and then time. Like Monday, 8 June 2020, probably 8 p.m. You can change the time if you want. This will be a one-time entry, only one day. So only one day entry, okay? Brief entry, very small entry. Theme, okay. Now, how did you meet Sachin Tendulkar? I have given you some scenarios over here. You can either pick up from here or create one of your own. It's all up to you. So I've written, won a lottery ticket. Maybe you won a lottery ticket wherein you got a chance to sit with Sachin and watch a match. Or a ticket to watch a match in the VIP area with Sachin Tendulkar. Maybe, you know, sometimes you have a packet of chips or a packet of biscuits or cookies in which you have these offers that, you know, you open the packet and then you might get a chance to watch a match in the Eden Garden or whatever. So maybe you took up a packet of chips like that. When you opened it, you got the ticket. You won the ticket wherein you could have watched your match with Sachin Tendulkar. Or bumped into Tendulkar when you were entering the gallery. So maybe when you were going into the gallery to grab your seat in the Eden Garden, you bumped into Sachin Tendulkar. That is how you met him. Or Sachin threw the ball towards the gallery and you caught it and he signed it for you. So there are some situations I've given here. It is not necessary for you all to stick to this. You can create your own situation or pick up anyone from here. Use figurative language to enhance your writing skills, such as I was happy as a lark. Now, we have done figures of speech. I told you if you use figures of speech, your language becomes very good to hear. The quality of the language increases very much. So you can use figurative language. I've given one example here. I was as happy as a lark. You can use any other figure of speech as well. What did you do when you met him? So when you met Sachin Tendulkar, what did you do? You can write, you clicked a photograph with him, you took his autograph, or maybe if you're a huge, huge fan of Sachin Tendulkar, you also went up to hugging him. Again, you can build up your own story. I'm just giving you a rough example. End the diary entry with a nice and happy feeling. So because this is a happy event for you, that you met Sachin Tendulkar, you should end it on a happy note as well. So this is about the first topic you will write down in your English 1 notebook. The second one is, imagine yourself to be a Martian. Martian is somebody who has come from the planet Mars. Now children, before I explain this topic to you all, I want you all to go back and think about the movie PK, where Aamir Khan was an alien who had come down to planet Earth and how he saw that people on Earth were so, so different from how they were on his planet. I just want you all to go back and think about it. You can also think about Koi Mil Gaya, because Koi Mil Gaya also had an alien. Now let's read this topic. Imagine yourself to be a Martian. Martian means somebody who is from the planet Mars. Describe your stay on Earth in the form of a diary. You can write this diary after your return or during your stay on Earth. Now, what you have to do, you have to think of yourself to be an alien from the planet Mars, and you have come to Earth. Now, you're seeing how things are so different on Earth. You have to write a diary entry either when you're already on Earth, you're having your experiences here, or when you have gone back to your planet, right? So anyone you can pick up. Now, how to write this? For this, I'm going to give you lesser instructions, because the first one I've given you a lot of instructions. This one, I want you all to think about the movies. Take the idea from these two movies. It will give you a lot of themes to write on. First, start with the day, date and time. This entry can be of 5 to 7 days. Write one entry for each day. So like the example diary entry which is given in your book, it's going to be like that. Because here you're explaining, you're writing about your stay on Earth. Maybe you stayed here for 5 days or 7 days or whatever. Don't exceed 7 days because then it becomes too much. Keep it from 5 to 7 days. Okay? You have to write one entry each day. Make small entries for every day, not very big. Theme: spaceship crashed and you landed on Earth. So it might be that your spaceship was passing through Earth, but it crashed and you landed here. You landed on Earth for a secret mission but got separated from your team. Maybe you came to Earth for some mission that the people of your planet had planned, but unfortunately you got separated from them. Or you landed on Earth to see how humans live. Or maybe you came to Earth purposely because you wanted to see how humans over here lived. Okay? Any theme you can take, or if you have something else in your mind, please go ahead and write about it. Then use figurative language to enhance your skills. Same thing, whenever you're writing something like a diary or any other writing skill, I will always suggest to use figurative language. Figurative language is figures of speech. It really makes your language sound so beautiful. What did you do on Earth? Now, when you were over here, what did you do? Please take examples from PK. You would get a lot of examples from that movie. How did you get back to your planet, or how do you plan to go back? So if you're writing about the about your experience when you've already reached back to your planet, then you can say that how did you reach your planet back. Or if you're still over here on Earth, then you might say that how do you plan to go back, because you have still not reached your planet back. This is how you have to frame your second topic. Both of this has to be written in your English 1 notebook. This is your homework. Thank you. That's all for today.